The audience is the confidant of the main character. So everybody in the movie doesn't really know what's going on in this guy's head, but the audience does. You hear his inner thoughts.
I think that was the first challenge cinematically, was how was the audience going to feel that John Doe was them, that they were going through what he was going through.
To be in this situation where you're limited by telling a story of somebody who is in this condition, you have to find whatever he was trying to find too, different ways to communicate, different ways to see what's out there. So we tried to do it as well with the camera.
Bend your wrists back. Turn them over. Get under the water. Just go under the water a little
more. What's interesting about working with Julian is that he's not interested in conventional coverage. He's an artist first, and he was more interested in seeing the character in the environment, which was so essential to who he was, rather than, you know, doing conventional coverage. So we started experimenting with that idea. What happens when you only see the world through one eye and you don't have any movability? Well, you start seeing your nose, you start seeing your glasses.
Necessity is the mother of invention. If I wanted to tell the story the right way, I needed the right tool. So I used a swing and tilt lens so it looked like you were looking out of his eye.
It's a very specific way of focusing the image, because you can photograph human face straight on and only focus on the nose, or only focus on an eye, or only focus on an ear. And when you do that, everything else becomes kind of diffused and out of focus.
The movie is about seeing, so I showed all different kinds of way of seeing. I put my glasses on top of the objective of the camera and the lens. I took latex and put it over the camera and sewed it together to sew up his eye.
I think pushing that point of view for as long as we do is a little painful for the audience, but you feel so connected. It's worth the journey once you're out of it, because you know you've lived in his shoes. You've been in that hospital bed. You've had those clothes put over your head. So I think there was an urgency and immediacy that it all helped create, because we were right there and in their face, and the actors were able to still make these incredibly personal performances.
Right into the camera.
I think it's really strange to act with a camera, not just because it's a camera, but also you're always told don't look at the camera. And now here all of a sudden, look at the camera. You have to look at the camera. You're interacting with the camera.
Put your face right up to the camera. Put your body over the camera.
When you work with a camera, it's really difficult, because I was afraid to become too self-conscious. I was afraid of that first, and not knowing if what I'm doing is good. Because when we play together as actors, there's a mirror effect. We can see if we're on the right spot, but when you play with a camera, you have nothing.
Alors vous allez cligner une fois pour oui, deux fois pour non.
C'est bien ma veine, j'ai deux créatures au pied de mon lit et je ne peux rien faire.
When we were shooting Matthew's point of view and the actors, actresses were playing to the camera, the cameraman was in Matthew's bed or in the wheelchair with the camera on his shoulder. But Matthew was in a soundproof box, maybe 20 feet off the set.
And I could hear what the actors were saying to the lens. And Julian told me, go and say what passed through your mind.
He could respond to it right away. And he could see exactly what was going on, because we had this monitor set up inside with him.
À vous maintenant.
Enlevez ce miroir.
Ouvrez la bouche.
Non.
Bien.
The scene with the mirror is actually one of the first times you see John Doe's face. And therefore, we had to have John Doe and the cameraman both squeezed into that point of view. This is the one scene where both those things had to really be together, because we were still playing that convention of his point of view. But in this case, he was in it a little bit. But Alatz did an amazing job at connecting the mirror and John Doe and her point of view all in this really narrow range. Everything was organic. Everything was kind of a naturalistic approach that Janusz did with his own effects, not any special effects that were done through computer. And even the blinks, Sometimes it was done just through an editorial fade and dissolve, but sometimes Janusz or the camera operator would just put his two fingers in front of the lens and create that shadow that then ended up becoming a blink.
Toute ma gratitude va à Claude Mandibille, dont on comprendra en lisant ces pages le rôle primordial qu'elle a joué dans leur écriture.
For the spinal sequence, I've used a hand-cranked camera. I'm using a little crank, little handle, and I'm moving physically by my hand. I'm moving the film as the film is going through the gate and being exposed. I can control the speed, so I'm altering the reality. And also I can wind the film back, which essentially I'm double exposing the film. And I can go forward, I can go backwards, and I can go forward again, I can go backwards again, which essentially I'm layering the images.
The unsung hero of the movie, technically, is Juliet Welfling, our editor, who did such an amazing job at timing all of this communication, the eye, the blink, the responses, the back and forth, the conversations that you have never seen before, and her ability to handle that language through the editing process is just so taken for granted because it's so seamless and so perfect.
It's got a lot of hair, so more wind from the right, more wind from the left.
When you put crew together, you're often approaching it much like casting. So you're looking at people that you think might work well together. Julian Schnabel is an extraordinary filmmaker. And right after we finished shooting, Janusz said to me, I feel like I walked into a Rolls Royce. I mean, he knew that he had been working with somebody and collaborating with somebody that was only gonna make him better. And I think it did.